You know, honestly, I have no qualms about saying that Choked is probably my most satisfying experience as an actor. Of course, Choked will be special for me, and it was a film that I think it was meant for the OTT, so I'm glad it came out, you know, on the digital space.
Hi guys, you're tuned into peepingmoon.com. Today we have with us someone special who is definitely going to get you choked in a good way. Let's not take it anything negative from Sayami here, who's going to give us a lowdown that why the year 2020 has been also, apart from other things, a good year when it comes to entertainment, good performance, and a lot of content to consume. Hi Sayami, how have you been?
Hi, thank you so much for having me over.
Sayami, right through you. If I have to ask you what 2020 is or has been overall, something on a positive note, something, a good takeaway you took from this year, which otherwise we all know was a little naram garam.
Honestly, you know, professionally, this has been probably the most positive year for me in my career so far, because I've had 3 releases. All of them have been accepted. They've all done well. So on the professional front, it has been very positive for me. So I'm, you know, very grateful that people actually, you know, had time to sit and watch the stuff that I was working on. You know, of course, it has been a difficult year. It's been a strange year, probably something that no one expected. In generations haven't seen something like this, but I think there always is a takeout from, you know, something like this, because we've had time to be at home, spend time with family. We've had, I think, just time to introspect on what we've been giving priority to, which probably hasn't always been correct. So I think, you know, it's just been a pause that was forced upon us, and I think that a lot of learning people have done in the past 8-9 months. Personally, for me, I've just probably become a more grateful person for the things I have.
Sayami, as a performer, as you said, 2020 has been a standout. Like, Choked was, I guess, the most acclaimed, one of the most acclaimed performances across beat critics to audience. We had you in Special Ops, in Breathe, you surprised us. There is a season 3 I'm hoping to see surely forward. But if you have to sum up 2020 for you as a performer, performance-wise, what was the most special one, if I may ask to you to be a little biased, and how each one of the performances, which was so different as a performer for you, how satisfying it was to get into 3 different shoes, maybe at simultaneously, because all came just right after the another.
You know, honestly, I have no qualms about saying that Choked is probably my most satisfying experience as an actor. And it was a very long journey, because Anurag had actually approached me little after Mirza. And, you know, then there was like 3 years of just waiting around, wondering ki ye project hoga, nahi hoga. I didn't know if it was going to happen. So the whole experience with Choked kind of just, you know, has made me I hope I can say a better actor, but it's definitely taught me a lot. You know, it really taught me a lot. And the writer working with Roshan, it was all just so much fun. We've all become one big family, and Choked will always be hold a very special place in my heart. You know, Breathe and Special Ops, both of it gave me a lot of visibility. Both the shows did very well. And shooting, it was great fun, because with Special Ops, we got to travel to a whole lot of places across the world, working with Neeraj Pandey, who I think is, you know, a master filmmaker in his own right. You know, and then just being able to watch KK sir, I feel KK Menon is such a talented actor. So even just being able to watch him, learn from him. Breathe, on the other hand, was a completely different experience, because I was playing a role which you know, I didn't know if I'd be able to pull off or not, because I'm like, I've never tried something like that. But we had Mayank, who was there giving me the correct guidance. There was Abhishek, Nitya, Amit, who were all so much fun to work with. And I just feel really blessed, really lucky that I've been able to play three such diverse roles in such a small span. So as an actor, that's something that I'm always looking forward to, and I hope I get to play many more different lives in the coming future.
Sammy, I have to ask you, maybe out of context it sounds, all three were one of the topmost performances for OTT. Like, the shows have done well. Choked was one of those beautiful mixes where you have a film on a digital platform. Was there ever an apprehension, because you had a bona fide big 70mm screen debut, that jumping from big to, I should not say small, jumping to something different, was there a scare ever? You were confident that this is the year, this is the time, and this is the right move I have to do as an actor.
Honestly, I felt that a film like Choked was very tailor-made for this. I mean, it is a smaller screen because you're watching it at home. So it came on an OTT platform. And I feel that it was a film which, you know, was very intimate, which was something where you could sit home and watch. And it wasn't necessarily like a big screen experience. I feel Mirza, I still stand by the fact that it was a film because it was shot with so much grandeur. It was shot with, you know, the way it was shot was a film where probably you needed to watch it on a big screen, you know. And with Breathe and with Special Ops, I feel that everyone was moving into the OTT space, not knowing where it was going, what it was going. But I actually signed Breathe a long time ago. So I was very confident that this is going to be the future and this is something I want to do. So there was no apprehension at all about moving from, you know, the big screen onto doing OTT stuff.
So Sammy, what has been your watch guide for 2020? Considering if we go through the content, oh my God, there is no dearth of content, no matter what. You say from films, you say from small screen to the OTT. We have been thankfully blessed in lockdown, maybe with some of the best performances. If I have to ask you as an actor, what were the performances, or maybe what were the shows or films which totally inspired you or you loved? Could you just give me your top few picks?
I mean, you know, you very correctly said it. If there wasn't all this content coming out, I really wonder what we would have done in lockdown, because, you know, we've all been sitting at home and binge watching all the content that's coming out. And fortunately, it's been such good content that, you know, you don't realize when, chalo, ek hafta gaya, 10 din gaya, you're already consuming the content so much. So I think from the list of stuff that's come out for me, undoubtedly Scam 92 is probably, you know, it is the best show that I've seen that's come from India. It was a show that, you know, didn't have too much hype around it. It just came very quietly and, you know, just showed us how brilliant it was. Like everyone else, I'm completely floored by what Prateek has done, because you know, we didn't know he has been acting for the last 13-14 years, but there's just so much talent in the country which you don't know about. And then when there's a show like this that comes out, that's when you kind of realize. I've known Shreya for some time, so I was very happy to see Shreya doing so well. And I have been a big fan of Hansal Mehta's work, be it Shahid or Aligarh. So whenever Hansal Mehta does something, you know it's going to be something of substance. But this show, I really, really, really loved. So for me, it's Scam that, you know, completely blew me away. Then of course there was Patal Lok, which I feel again is such a good show, because it again gave rise to someone like a Jaydeep Palawar. There was Neeraj Kabi, who's actually my one of my teachers, so it's always so wonderful watching Neeraj sir perform. And again, Prosit and Avinash are two very talented makers, so I'm looking forward to more work from both of them. There was, of course, I don't mean to sound boastful, but then, you know, Special Ops and Family Man, both of them were in the same genre, but because the makers are so different, I feel that both the shows had their own, even if Family Man came out, I didn't have a problem watching Special Ops like a month later, because I like truly enjoyed both the shows, the way they were made. And of course, KK Menon, Manoj Bajpayee, they're like institutions of acting. So, you know, you can just like watch and learn so much from them. So I think both these shows, and of course I'll have a bias towards Breathe because it's something that I have, you know, worked on. And I hope the people who haven't watched it yet, I hope that, you know, they make time and watch Breathe.
Lovely. Sammy, have there been there any films per se in theatrical experiences which you thought that thoda sa aur time mil jata, we could have been to theater and watched those films also, anything on those lines or anything which is definitely on your list jo bhi aapko dekhna hai but time nahi mila?
Nahin, actually I didn't really miss the matlab maine I'm not missed the films that I watched, like I really liked Raat Akeli Hai because Hani Trehan is someone who's you know, been a casting director, he's auditioned me so many times, so you know that okay, this person is someone who's going to come up with something special. And then of course there's Nawaz, there's Radhika, but I think it was a really well made murder mystery. You know, sometimes it becomes a little cliched and things like that, but I thought Raat Akeli Hai was a very very well made film. I am a big fan of Anurag Basu. So maybe Ludo I would have liked to see on the big screen, just because like maybe that's one film I would have liked to watch on the big screen. I thoroughly enjoyed it and enjoyed the music, enjoyed the entire star cast. So that was a film which I really enjoyed as well. And of course, Choked will be special for me. And it was a film that I think it was meant for the OTT. So I'm glad it came out, you know, on the digital space. So personally for me, even if I wasn't a part of Choked, it was a film that I would have really enjoyed watching because, you know, I'm a Kashyap fan. It's always interesting to see how he comes up with, you know, some really absurd ideas of like money coming out of a sink and, you know, just him who can do that. So I think probably even Choked, if people haven't watched it, please go watch Choked.
And Sam, if I lastly have to ask you to be a little selfish, if given a chance, now I'm not asking you to replace anyone, but just hypothetically, if a role you would love to steal and you would have done it in a jiffy in the last few months or in this year, a performance which like made you like, oh my God, I wish I could have done that. In the last couple of months.
Oh, that's a tough one. In the last couple of months. I think probably Arya. I really enjoyed the film. And I'm obviously young for the character. But eventually at some point, I would love to play a character like what Sushmita ma'am has done with Arya. Because I felt, again, Ram Madhvani is a great filmmaker. So he knew exactly what he wanted. But that's a role which I'd have loved to do.
But thank you so much, Yami. Your picks are definitely wonderful. And I hope we start 2021 sitting down with you again, discussing more performances, more films, and to more magic and lots of content.
Thank you so much.